This is John Young with the Disc Jockey News. Today we're looking at the American Audio CPX 10A. We have a 10-inch two-way cabinet, 250 watts, great sound, great looking cabinet, incredible price point on this thing, solid, durable, really kind of a sweet little cab. We've already done a couple of videos on the CPX speakers from American Audio, and I've already had some questions. One question I had was, since the price point is so killer on these, they were like, for a backup, if we had these as a backup system, what is the minimum amount of gear we would need to have with these to have it be a backup DJ system? So we're going to tackle that one right now. We've got our two CPX 10As right here from American Audio. The front, of course, looking nice. The back. The back has for inputs. I wanted to run through this quickly. We've got our mic input, which we're actually going to be using that particular input on this speaker. I've got two XLR cables. I've got a cable that's 1/8 inch to RCA. I've got a microphone, and I have my cell phone. That's my kit for today. What we're going to do is we're going to run our microphone in. Now our mic level for this application is going to be right here. And for this application, I've chosen to use a handheld wired microphone that has a switch on the side of it. If I were going to be using these as a backup, I would want to have a switch on the side so I can set the volume of the microphone, and then I'd be able to control on and off with the switch. So we have our microphone set up. Next, you'll see that we have a line level. The line level controls two different ports. It can control the RCA, and it controls the XLR that goes in right here. So if I were coming from my board, my mixer, I would go right in here. But today, I'm not doing that. I'm using that 1/8 inch to RCA. For music source today, I'm just going to be using my cell phone. I could be using a laptop, I could be using a tablet, what have you. A tablet, of course, would work fabulous, or even a cell phone, now that there's software and such that you can actually do everything right from the phone. But for this application, we're using cell phone. So I have a microphone plugged in, I have my music plugged in. My controls, I'll be controlling my microphone here, I'll be controlling my music level here. And now the volume is the next one. The volume will control what's coming into the speaker. The mic and the line will control these two coming in, and they will pass that information through on this output, which is what we're going to use to hook the two speakers together. So they're going to be coming out of the output, and I can do that with XLR, or I can do it with quarter inch jack. You can see right there, quarter inch jack. But we're going to be using XLR. And then we're going to be going in to the line in on this particular speaker. Now I've been playing with this a little bit to get the balance so I can have my sound equal back and forth, and I think I've got it down. Okay, now we're going to power up our speakers. I think we've got them both on. So on this particular unit, this is our second unit. This will be our first one. We'll call this one our brains of the system, and this one will be the brawn. No, it doesn't work. But this one's our first one. We're going to be going in. We're going to have our mic level that we're going to control because we're using the microphone on this one. The line level, we aren't using any music yet, so that's all the way down. And we're going to leave our volume at about 12 o'clock and our bass and treble at 12. On a second one now, since we're running into the line level, I'm going to set that at 12 o'clock also. So at 12 o'clock line level, 12 o'clock volume, 12 o'clock bass treble. I'm not going to use the mic level, so that's all the way off. So turn that mic down. Check, 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 check. 1, 2, 2, 2. I've got a microphone on this one. And check, 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 check. There we go. I got microphone coming out of each of them right now. So if I need to make an announcement, this is what I need. Now let's try music. So I've got my mic level there, and of course my microphone I'm using happens to have a switch on it, so then I don't have to be adjusting, which if I'm doing a live event, this would work. I'm going to throw something on. Okay, so a couple things I wanted to check on this while we were doing this is I wanted to make sure as it sets if they were equal as far as volume and such. And the way I've got it set right now at 12 o'clock and controlling everything with this one, they sounded like they were pretty much right on. So if this one is at one, this is at the same volume. So that was pretty cool. Sound quality sounded really, really quite good. So I'm hearing the bass on this, I'm getting a nice bass response, and I'm hearing basically full range. Up through, there's not a whole lot of highs, I'm not hearing much for cymbals on this, but I don't believe this particular track that I just kind of randomly pulled has a ton of a ton of cymbal in that. So to wrap up this video, I ran these for about a half an hour here, and I ran them pretty much wide open as much as I could give them. Playing a variety of music, some rock, some older, some newer, some dance stuff, and the sound is still fabulous after playing for quite a long time at a high volume. I think for the smaller events, they're gonna be perfect. For backup, awesome. The looks are good, the sound is good, price is excellent. If you need a little bit more, you put a sub and cross that over so you're rolling off those low frequencies. I think this could be a really great standalone system for a lot of DJs. We'll put a link in the description below so you can check out the American Audio CPX 10A or the 8 or the 12 or the 15A from American Audio. This is John Young with the Disc Jockey News.